ask the Holy Spirit, what's the best way to start this video? And the Holy Spirit suggested I say, what is wrong with right now? What is wrong with right now? Now I recognize this is a, I believe, a Sailor Bob Adamson affirmation. It's not a question, it's an affirmation. And of course he was a student, got it from Srinivasagadatta Maharaj, who got it through his guru, who asked him to just simply say, I am, I am, I am. Another affirmation. So Sailor Bob Adamson would say, what's wrong with right now? So let's try that. What's wrong with right now? This is not a question. Maybe that's what's wrong with right now. Leaf blower. Okay, but we'll keep practicing. It's not a question. This is the whole key. We have to get this, that we're not getting the affirmation. Get it, that it's not anything to get. It's something to hold in our hands, as it were, to hold around us. Let the vibe, the presence of the declaration, what is wrong with right now? What is wrong with right now? What is wrong with right now? And when you do it this way, I feel this tremendous it just hits like a hurricane. You know, it's just wow. It hits like a leaf blower. And it stuns into this ordeal, immediate ordeal, which is great. What is wrong? What is wrong with right now? Now, this is not a question. It's stating a fact. Okay, it's a way of stating a fact in a question format. What is wrong with right now? What is wrong with right now? What is wrong with right now? And we must not let the mind thinking grab a hold of this. Hands off. Hands off. This is a fact. We're not bringing this up for discussion. This is a fact. What is wrong with right now? This contains the full potency of truth. What is wrong with right now? We're not saying, well, whoa, 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 what do we mean by this? What do we mean? No. We're not searching for meaning. It carries the potency. Feel the potency. Declarations, affirmations carry a potency. It's like a medicine. Take the medicine. What is wrong with right now? Pointing to, there's nothing wrong with right now, but putting into a question format, it's like a gel cap. We seem to be able to swallow it better than like a tablet. If we say there's nothing wrong with right now, we might have trouble getting that down, but it's a nice gel cap. What is wrong with right now? 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 This seems to devastate our search, as it should. We're devastating our search. What are we searching for? A fix for right now. A fix. Our search, our purpose, is to fix what's wrong with right now. But what is wrong with right now? What is wrong with right now? So this challenges our whole purpose, our search, challenges the ego. Just, what is wrong with right now? Not asking the ego a question, just directly confronting and challenging and say, hey, what is wrong with right now? And then don't play the devil's advocate and try to answer from the ego standpoint. Don't do it. You just keep affirming, what is wrong with right now? What is wrong with right now? See, the mind, will, like that leaf blower, will, you know, at a distance, it's still, you know, doing its thing. It doesn't matter. We're not engaging it. What is wrong with right now? What is wrong with right now? We're not looking to find what's wrong with right now. It's a way of stating that there's nothing wrong. It's a way of stating it that seems to slip past our defenses better. What is wrong with right now? It helps with our continuity problem to put it in that way. Because at least there seems to be some question involved. We're always questing, we've been questing and questioning. So we put it in the form of a question. Say, oh, that sounds familiar to me. See, there's familiarity there. What is wrong with right now? And then it seems as though we're addressing the ego, although we're not. We don't play the devil's advocate and have the ego answer. But at least the format of question, addressing a question, etc., is still there. So this helps with our continuity problem, our continuity fear. What is wrong with right now? Of course, deep down we're saying, oh wow, there's nothing wrong with right now. And like panicking, sort of like, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. What do I do about that? What do I do about it? What do I do about it? There's nothing wrong. There's nothing wrong. Oh my gosh. You stay calm. You stay calm and poised and silent. And let this panic subside a little bit. Shock. Stunned. There's nothing wrong with right now. Yeah, what is? We're looking. What is wrong with right now? Is not all 100% abiding in pure spaciousness right now? Is it? Yes. But we try not to go to the answer like this too soon. It's a little premature. Keep the burn going. What is wrong with right now? What is wrong with right now? Now it actually brought up some sort of memory of when I was quite young and I was desperately fighting against the pressures of the world. And I remember how adamant and fiery I was to try and prevent being pushed into this belief there was something wrong with right now. And eventually I succumbed. But it brought practice feeling of like asserting, you know, there's what is wrong with right now? What do you mean? What is wrong with right now? What is wrong with right now? By the way, whenever you find something that's helpful from any teacher, use it. Use it. Be a spiritual musician. Be a spiritual musician. Okay. And those of you who are musicians know what I'm talking about. You're listening to songs on the radio. What are you listening for? Or on CDs or whatever, on your MP3 these days. What are you listening for? You're listening for riffs, for bridges, for all sorts of little ear candy. And you say, hey, I can use that. Wow, I could use that. I could use that, especially if you're a composer. And then you can put together a song. I mean, I'll be listening to songs, and later on, I can put together like a really great song. And I realize, oh my gosh, I was stealing from this song and this song and this song, and I rearranged and put some innovation into it, and here's this jewel, you know. But I got it from these other songs, of course. So, of course, be a spiritual musician. If Sailor Bob Adamson says something, what is wrong with right now? Use it. Use it. Of course, where did he get it from? See? It's okay to use, be a spiritual musician and take from, you know, from whatever sources you want. Absolutely. All spiritual teaching is in the spiritual domain, as it were, public domain, spiritual domain, actually. It's free to use, so to speak. You can use it. Use it. Use it. You don't have to say, well, he's my teacher or something. No. There's only one teacher. It's the teacherless teacher. It's the no teacher, so to speak. It's the no teacher. And it's really the Holy Spirit, it's really the grace of God is the teacher. So where does this all come from? From our own grace, from our own grace. So we are it. We all own it. We all own it. We all own it. So don't be afraid to be spiritually eclectic in some ways. Be a spiritual musician. And you come across something and say, hey, you ask the Holy Spirit, what do you suggest? And then it comes out. Say, hey, that's what Sailor Bob Adamson used. And the Holy Spirit says, yeah, that's great. It's very effective. Try using it now. I say, okay. It's like a musician will listen to someone, how someone breaks up an E chord or something. They'll say, wow, I really like that. So learn it. Learn it. Use it. Use it. You'll put your own flavor into it anyway. It's all about using what's effective for you right now. What's wrong and what's wrong with right now. It's like smelling salts. It's really like smelling salts. And in smelling salts, does the intellect really have to be involved? Not really. Not really. It thinks it's reviving you, but it's not. It's the smelling salts that are reviving you. So the intellect thinks that it's the one that is waking us up, so to speak. Not really. No. It's these powerful smelling salts. What's wrong with right now? So allow this affirmation, these declarations into your system. Allow them into your system, your belief system. Allow them into your belief system. And I can feel it. It's like going through central, you know, it's all the way into my belief system. It's challenging my belief system. Allow this challenge to your belief system to permeate the depths of your belief system through and through. That's where the reverberation, the burn, the ache begins. It's being challenged, at least it's being challenged, and it's falling apart. This one penetrate to the depths, you know, the belief system. It seems to just be spreading throughout the whole belief system. What is wrong with me? What is wrong with right now? What is wrong with right now? Our entire lives we've been believing that there's something wrong with right now. Even though deep within we know that's not true. So we need to take a stand here and say, whoa, wait a minute, what is wrong with right now? Something wrong right now. It is not right now. It doesn't mean it's true. It doesn't mean there's something actually wrong right now. We can believe there is, but is that a fact? Is that a fact? Or is that trying to play God, trying to be better than God, actually? To say that there's something wrong with right now is to claim there's something wrong with God. To do this, it requires determination. In other words, you have to be desperate and determined, really desperate. Desperation is not something to be feared so much, because you can use it to really focus in like this. We're told not to be desperate in this world. Why? Well, when we're truly desperate, we can focus in. I remember when I was young how desperate I was to try to maintain my sanity in a world that demanded insanity. I remember how desperate I was. But then we're told, oh, you've got to now just be, don't be desperate at all. That's bad form. So it's very bad form. But desperation is what's needed. We need to feel as if this declaration has to take hold, take root, as it were. It's more important than our next breath, that we actually desire it more than we desire our next breath. What's wrong with right now? What is wrong with right now? What's wrong with right now? What's wrong with right now? So the objections of the world lasted a long time there, like a leaf blower. And finally, you know, silence, the objections fall away. Eventually, we get to a point where we're willing to drop it, you know, and then just a teacher just saying that, the guru just says that, what's wrong with right now? And eventually, but you know, everyone has a different time frame. Usually you hear someone who's gone along for many, many years on the path, read everything, studied everything, tried every meditation, and then finally there's just some little statement, you know, ends it. Nirvana, the light is blown out, the candle's blown out, so to speak. The flickering, the instability is gone, the instability is gone. Enter Nirvana, which is, you know, the stability of right now. Nirvana is the stability of right now. Moksha is the stability of right now. The samadhi is the stability of right now. Vision of oneness is the stability of right now. So you don't want to leave Nirvana. Once you think you left Nirvana, then it's very difficult to accept it back, as it were. Because leaving it requires all sorts of defensive maneuvers to try and stabilize yourself within a lie, within instability. So the effort to stabilize ourselves within an unstable position of believing, you know, we're fundamentally unstable, and then trying to stabilize ourselves, that's what brings all the trouble. And we have massive strategies that are automatic, habitual, and that's the trouble of, because then we think, well, if we let drop all those strategies, we'll be unstable. No, we'll realize nirvana is stable. That right now is totally stable. It was the attempt to leave right now that was unstable. And then we try to stabilize that. So we think we let go of our attempt to stabilize it, we'll be unstable. Well, we would be unstable if we held on to the idea of instability, which we already are unstable with that, just in spite of our defenses. But if we realize there is no instability with right now, then we won't be unstable, we'll be stable. So the flickering light, nirvana, out with the flickering light, you know, out with the breeze, out with the breeze, no more breeze, no more flickering light, no more movement, no more instability, nirvana, no more instability, without instability. See, the right now lacks instability. And we who want to fix instability, of course, overlook right now. And we see time instead of right now. We don't understand that right now extends forever. Because everything is always abiding in God, glorious zero dimensionality. So it extends forever. So we overlook it, instead we see time. We see time. We see the motion of things indicating relative instability. One thing moving in relation to something else. Oh, it's not stable. Like I'm sitting here, I see the fly moving around. Oh, the fly is not stable. It's moving around. Whereas I'm stable, but there's instability. You feel instability. But keep in mind that wherever the fly goes, it's 100% abiding in pure spaciousness. Always. It never is closer or farther away, nearer or farther away. It's always there. It's always there. It's always here. It's always right now. Doesn't matter what the motion is or lack of motion. It's me sitting here, I'm also 100% here, now. Everything is always 100% abiding in God, always. And this extends forever. So there's no time to this fact at all. There's no change whatsoever. So how can time be relevant? Time is the sequential measurement of change. If there isn't going to be any change, what use do we have to say, well, you know, to measure with time? There's no time measurement we can apply. It's zero. Zero time. How long does it last? Zero. And zero. We conceptually, verbally, we can say both is and it isn't. It both is and it isn't, and it's neither is nor isn't. Right? It's zero, zero, zero. What is zero? Well, endlessness, actually. Foreverness. So what is wrong with right now? All of this sinks in gradually. The whole idea of relativity, of thinking that there's instability, because stuff's moving. Stuff, you know, can seem unstable to me. It's like, whoa, yeah, wow, that this bottle suddenly, you know, became unstable, right? It became unstable. Whoa. So, wow, instability, I'd say. But as far as God is concerned, was there ever any instability? Is something need? Does God need to catch something? Does pure spacious need to catch something? Oh, something's falling into pure spacious. I better catch it, or else it's gonna fall out of pure spaciousness. Is that true? So we've gone through life denying the very ground of our being, of all being. And of course, it's very regretful. I'm feeling very much regretful over this. And we need to give a little bit of time for our severe regrets. There's no instability in God at all. There is no instability. All instability is only form-based, it's relative, okay? Here's one form, and this bottle, you know, seems to be unstable. His position seems to be indeterminate, right? Whoa, you know, whoa. Wow, suddenly something became very unstable. Did it become unstable for God, for glorious zero-dimensionality, for pure spaciousness? No, there was no point at all in any of this where it was not entirely, this entire bottle was entirely abiding in pure spaciousness. And it's not the spaciousness outside the bottle, it's also the spaciousness of the glass, of the space in the bottle, of the water, of everything. It's all one seamless. It never was never apart from it. At any moment was it ever apart from pure spaciousness, from God. So there was not the slightest bit of instability. None. Zero. So what's wrong with right now? What is wrong with right now? In other words, saying, where is the instability of right now? Where is the instability of right now? This can very well bring up very strong reactions and regrets, and I feel very much that way. Where is the instability right now? Regrets of having lived a life, a false belief, you know, that I didn't want to live. Trying to be a hero of playing with instability and trying to bring out good outcomes, you know, of instability all the while. Overlooking God. The world wants us to make the world more stable, make things more stable. Overlooking God. Stability. What is unstable right now? What is it that's unstable about right now? Don't struggle for an answer. Just keep holding that. What is wrong with right now? What is wrong with right now? Just keep the burn going. Keep putting oxygen on the fire. See, this is not about how quick can you answer the question. It's actually how long can you entertain this statement, this declaration? How long can you put up with this burn? Because if we really entertained it, we would realize right now. We would realize it. So it's just putting up with it for as long as you can tolerate it. Not trying to dismiss it with a glib answer, you know. Now some can do this like doing a video like I'm doing it, or some could do it like through writing. You can be writing this, or some maybe could be doing it through music. Sometimes it helps to be, for your body to be just doing something on autopilot a little bit. I'm just sitting here talking. There might be ways, you know, different ways to really feel it sink in. And keep yourself from trying to, from dismissing it, intellectually dismissing it. This one's hitting really hard. Which is great. I'm sure, in hindsight, looking back at this time, I'll think it's the best of times. Wow. Because this is the path, and you look back on very fond memories, so to speak, of the time spent like this. Even though right now it seems to be, you know, there's discomfort, and it's the ache. There's this ache, you know, this deep ache. Wow. I wouldn't trade it for anything. I would not trade this for any, you know, in the world, any situation in the world. Of course, we leave out realization. That's not tradable. But I would not trade this for anything anyone else is experiencing in the world right now. Would not. This is the best. So realize this and accept it. The spiritual practices, when you do this practices, you're really having the best experience in the world. Okay? And that's something you trade it for at all. Would you be trading this for like a walk with a friend through a forest path? No way. No way. Trade it for a round of golf? No way. Yeah. Great meal at a restaurant? A concert? No way. No. The world will tell you, especially when you're young, there's so many things that are so much better. Why are you just on the spiritual focused here? You gotta know. What a waste of time. What a horrible waste of time having done, you know, lived a life somewhat. And thinking, hey, maybe this is great. Maybe this experience is great. Maybe this is great. And then, no, it's not at all. I mean, this is what's great, is saying, hey, what's wrong with right now? Hey. What's wrong with right now? And just feeling this, just, you know, crushing the police system. It's just, so the really smart, cool crowd are the ones doing spiritual practice like this. They're not wasting their time on these superficial stuff that is just virtually worthless by comparison. What is wrong with right now? And there is a lot of instability within the police system. I don't try to say mental, emotional, label it. It's just, I can feel it. just like the whole sort of overall structure is, you know, it's like shifty like that. Is this like a house of cards? Is all coming down? A house of cards is coming down. It's like a saying these declarations is like a house of cards coming down. It's just it's part of just collapsing. What is wrong with right now? Very good to train yourself not to pay much attention to the body. Otherwise, you're going to get completely obsessed, and it's going to be a nightmare for you. I tend to really pay very little attention to the body. I don't label what's going on. I don't think about what's going on. I just think about the affirmation and just rest in that. Hey, what's wrong with right now? What is wrong with right now? And then I realize that the body, that the structure is undergoing ordeal, so we're intelligent about this. So we're just patient, we just sit there patiently. It's like you hit your shin or something. Oh, okay, I hit my shin, all right. Let me just hang out for a while until it feels better, whatever. But some people will obsess and look at it. Oh, what is this? Oh, what is this? Oh my God. And that really will then just freak you out. If you're trying to follow every little sensation and nuance in the body, that's a nightmare. Yeah, is my heart still beating? Yes. Okay, fine. Everything's fine then. Sorry. Yeah, everything's fine. If you happen to feel a little lightheaded and faint and stuff, maybe your blood pressure's gone down a little bit. Absolutely, that can happen. Just like our blood pressure goes up when we're running a race or something, right? Pulse, blood pressure goes way up, and we don't think like, oh, I'm gonna die. No, because in here, blood pressure may go down, it's possible, because we're sort of in a state of shock. Pay much attention to it. Just say, okay, well, drink a lot of water, drink electrolytes, and have a lot of salt. So it is tremendous when you're able to get to this burn, this ache. That means you've allowed it into your system and it's having its effect. Tremendous milestone. I never used to be able to do that. So all mental. I'd say, okay, what do you mean by that? What's wrong with right now? Okay, now right now, what do you mean by right now? What's wrong? What do you mean by what's wrong? And you know, it never gets in. Right? You're like a guard there, and you're guarding. And you say, let me look at your credentials. Your pass, please. Yeah. Is that your real name? That picture doesn't look like you. Is that really your picture? Okay, now who okayed this? Yeah. And you're interrogating, it never gets in past the gate. But here, you drive through. The secret is you don't stop at the gate and say yes to the guard, you know. You just drive right through and wave to the guard. And, you know, I own this place. I own the place. But if you stop and say, guard, I need to check in. And then the guard say, oh, yeah, of course. Okay, let's see. And you've told them, delay you. But here we don't do that. We just say, what's wrong with right now? this one just brings up tremendous regret. Wasted life. But I'll tell you this, the whole key to life is to catch the fact you've wasted your life. Then you won't have another one. You won't have another one. If you don't catch it during your life, you will certainly have another life. So you have to catch it at some point in your life. You have to see, oh my God, I wasted my life. And then the recognition of that, you recognize what this existence is all about. It's all about wasting our lives. And when you recognize that's all I've been doing, and I don't need to anymore, and no more need for incarnation, identification. So, of course we're going to feel regret, and we're realizing, oh my God, my life's been totally wasted, just spinning my wheels in time. Time is the waste. Time is a waste of time. Time is the waste. Yeah. Oh, that's a delusion. It's a delusion. And of course, when you see through the delusion of time, you don't need form anymore. You don't need it. You can keep your form, but you don't need it. It's not because you don't need to keep believing in relative instability, of which form is required to believe in that form. Form is required to believe in time. And time is the measure of instability, relative instability. When you see there is no instability with now, you don't need time, you don't need form, you don't even need space, so to speak, or time-space, which is measuring out instability, right? Like, you know, how high did this, you know, bottle go? How much instability was there? You're right, measuring that. Don't need to measure it. So as much as possible during the day, put yourself through this ordeal. I'm trying to do it, you know, 3, 4, 5 times a day, even more now. Once a day is the initial goal, for sure. Put yourself through the ordeal once a day. And then after you're really good, you really can do that, then maybe twice a day, 3 times, and then, like right now, I'm so desperate, I'm speeding it up, you know, more. But you don't have to say, well, I have to do it so much, otherwise you'll quit. But for sure, once a day, put yourself through this ordeal, be the spiritual warrior. Spiritual warrior is one that does every day, goes through this ordeal every day. The rest are dilettantes, you know, armchair generals. Be on the front lines. Be on the front lines. You won't regret it. You won't. That's one thing you will never regret. Don't sit back and just say, oh, somebody else is doing something. Okay, somebody else. You be on your own front lines. You have your own huge situation, spiritual awakening, recognition. So you're totally into it. You're totally into it. Be totally into it. Recognize your wasted life. Be totally into recognizing your wasted life. Believing in time. Believing in instability. Believing that this relative instability is somehow total, actual instability, you know, ultimate, absolute instability. It's not. recognizing you lived your life without God. The more you can see this, the closer you get to dropping this, you know, to time, dropping time. You say, wow, what a waste. The stability's always been here. The whole time I was here, the perfect stability of God was everywhere, always. And I was just overlooking it. Trying to fix instability, trying to fix something. So of course you're going to have form if you're trying to fix instability. You can't have instability without form, relative instability. So you couldn't even work on fixing anything. So when we want to be greater than God, first we have to say there's something wrong with God that we can fix, that we can do better than that. Right? We can do better than that. And that requires form. It requires then time. To make it better, time to measure instability. And so we've come bound to form and time. Thinking that, oh no, I'm just, you know, working on fixing something. Making it right. Making instability seem beautiful. Because he say, no, you see, we're seeing a facet to reality. We think we're seeing something in reality that's not there. We found some problem with reality, and we're fixing it, we think. Capacity to do this gets better and better and better. It's just like anything else. You exercise, you get better at it. In no way did I start out as good at these exercises. In fact, I was terrible. I was so terrible I couldn't even start. And the problem is, you think, well, maybe I can do 2 or 3 minutes. It's not enough. You think, what's the use? It's not. I can't do it long enough. So what's the use? Which is why it's super important to. When you feel very determined, to seize upon that determination and make sure you do something for a long period of time to prove it to yourself you can do it, to prove it. Once you prove it to yourself, then it's so much easier to continue. Because when you do it for a long period of time, you realize the effectiveness of it and you say, wow, that was incredibly effective. Because remember prior you said, well, I can only do it for a couple minutes and I've tried, I don't feel any effectiveness. Because I haven't given it time to permeate our belief system, you know, it may just barely be beginning and they say, okay, all right, that's enough, and you short-circuit it. And then you claim, well, you see, it doesn't work. So to do it a long period of time, you feel its effectiveness, saying, I know it works, I know I can do it, I know it works, so I can keep doing it. So the path is two aspects. One is that all that push, when you feel determination and desperation, you say, I just have to sit down and let this permeate and just sit there in the permeation, just abide with it and stick with it as long as I can. There's that big push, and then there's also the daily continuing with that. Is you break the ice and then you keep going so the ice doesn't freeze up again. So it's both. You know, some say, well, I like to just do these bursts of effort. And others say, I like to do continuous effort. Well, you have to do both. You have to do both. Bursts are very essential. And so is the follow-up is very essential. Because the burst will show you the way, but it won't entirely, you know, melt the continuity, evaporate the continuity. You have to keep doing it and keep doing it. It's like you break the block of ice. but there's still lots of huge chunks of ice. But at least you know the ice is breakable. And then you go to work on breaking those little chunks. You have a big chunk and you bam, it may shatter into four or five big chunks. You say, oh, it's breakable. Okay, now you got to break down those other chunks into little pieces. The more you break the block of ice into little pieces, the quicker it evaporates, right? If you have a solid block of ice and you sit it, let it sit there in the sun, it's going to evaporate, but very slowly, actually, because the surface area is very minimal. But if you break that big block of ice up into many, many, many little small pieces, you know, it's going to, evaporation is going to be very fast. So that's what we're doing here. So you have to know the block is breakable. And once you know that, then you got to keep working on breaking the blocks up into smaller pieces. Now, what I'm feeling now is I'm feeling great sorrow about leaving, you know, ready to leave the path, finish it, you know. I don't really want to finish it. It's like been such an incredible experience, such an amazing time that, you know, you hate to see it go. Hate to see it go, actually. It's been my life, so there's so many memories, so much water under the bridge, and you're bringing it to an end, you know, it's like, wow. There's not a lot of desire for it to totally come to an end, but I can feel that it's at that point. Maybe I can honor it, you know, by in some way. The trophies are in the trophy case, the plaques are on the wall, you know, and you can honor your path. Yeah, it's hard to bring it to an end. Really, the path was really honoring reality, honoring right now. So, and accepting right now, it's kind of the honor remains. The honor remains. Exactly. Certainly attachment to the path that happens. It's been your experience. You're experiencing. You know, what? Oh, no more sessions of this burn, you know, no more of that. Come on. It doesn't get any better than this, hardly. What's wrong with right now? What is wrong? Okay, the burn is still there. The impact is still there, still being felt. But I feel it settled in. Well, settled in, so. Be it ever so humble, there's no place like home. So be it ever so stressful, difficult, there's no place like the efforts you've put forth in your life. Those are the days of your life. And this battle has been my life. It's like a spiritual warrior my whole life. Every day, there's money, you know, battles and battles and battles. And for finally there to be peace and no more battles, you know, wow. We'll see what that's like. Okay, very great. That's it for this one.